Hey guys, what's up? We are That Horror Couple. I'm Kaylee.
And I'm Rob.
And we just got back from the Upside Down. And
Holy Lord.
It was so good.
Just when you think things couldn't get any more wild, Beckner's like, hold my beer.
Yep. There you go.
They delivered too.
They did.
What was it? It was like the first episode.
Papa was like 1 hour and 25 minutes, and the second episode was at like 2 hours and 30 minutes. Like, yeah, so wow.
It was like a movie and then some.
Yes, yes.
It was good.
Yes.
Let's talk about it. Right away, I gotta say, what I liked is that the new episodes kind of like picked up right where the season left off.
Yes.
Where we literally see the aftermath of the battle between Vecna, between, what's his real name?
Henry Krill/Vecna/1.
Yeah, so she launches his ass into the upside down, mm-hmm. and then we see like the bloodiness and all that, and right behind her is Papa like,
yeah.
The fuck you do? Not in my house.
Yeah.
And she's like, Papa, I do my thing.
And she's like, I'm ready. I'm going to save my friends.
Yeah. She's like, I'm going to go do it.
Yeah. And we actually get a little bit of more of a backstory with Papa, I feel like, throughout the season.
Yeah.
It feels like, you know, he's not a good guy, but I feel like his reasons, like, saying he wanted to just protect Eleven this whole time.
Yeah,
I guess I kind of agree and see where he's trying to come from. It just comes off, like, bad.
I feel like there was, like, a negative vibe around him, but I feel like there was a point where we did find out he does care for Eleven.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And, I think there was a point where, like, he could have, like, turned on her, but he didn't.
Yes.
He let her free. He's mm-hmm. like, go with your friends. Go with your pineapple pizza-eating stoners.
Yeah. And that's where Mike and Eleven are reunited again. Yeah. I was so happy about that. I love the two of them. And it was really sad, but Will's speech to Mike in the van on the way there, how he's like, Mike, you're the heart of this group. You know, look at this drawing. He's like, well, Eleven, you know, she had me draw this,
It's pretty obvious to me that he kind of
he's like in love with Mike. Yeah, I mean, like, really sad.
It's 1986, and he's trying to let his friend know he has feelings for him.
Yeah, so I can only imagine how hard.
Unless it just seems like that to me.
I think so. He definitely has feelings for Mike, and it's really sad.
Well, that was a nice scene where he showed him the painting he mm-hmm. drew him.
Yeah.
And then he said, you're the heart of us.
Yeah.
He said, you're
we
the
need
leader.
You. Yeah.
We need you.
Mm-hmm. Eleven needs you.
Then he breaks down.
Yeah.
And Mike's just like, whatever, dude.
Yeah, that was kind of sad. I was like, his friend's like crying, and he's like,
your friend's crying, dude. And he's just like,
yeah.
Sissy ass.
Yeah. I also really love seeing Paul Reiser back as Dr. Owens. Like, I loved him from Alien. So, you know, at first I was like, why is he taking her back to the laboratory? I thought he was a good guy, but he does try to help her in the end and try to get her out. And no, I just really like the character.
I feel like both doctors, they kind of did have their own feelings for Eleven.
Yeah.
They had their own ways of going about it, though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, they did disagree with each other, but at the end of the day, they both cared for Eleven.
Yes.
In their own way, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they both did. I really love at the end how, like, all the characters are, like, reunited, mm-hmm. especially Eleven and Hopper. Like, I like how they waited till the end
for them to reunite.
Like, that was, it was just, oh, it was amazing. I was, like, bawling. It was so good.
You gotta remember, though, like, you know, we've seen Hopper this whole time with the whole Russia battle,
mm-hmm.
but, like,
Eleven thought he was dead.
She didn't think he was even alive. Mm-hmm. So, like, I like how casually he walked in. He's like, hey, kid.
Yeah.
Like, I was like, oh, dude, this is awesome, man.
I know. And then him and Mike have, like, a special relationship now, too. They were hugging. I just loved in season 3 how he was like, Grandma's sick, Mike. Get in the car. He was like, yeah.
Well, he was blaming Mike. He's like, that bastard, Mike.
Yeah.
He's like, he's turning my Eleven into some, like, you know, he's a bad influence.
Yeah. But they have a good relationship now, which is great. I love seeing that.
It is nice to see. Yeah.
Yeah.
But what I liked is, you know, there were hints like the back of Will's neck.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
It kind of tied it back to the first one.
Yeah.
Where, like, you know, the original, like, Demogorgon monster was, like, after
the Mind Flayer.
Mm-hmm. I went like this.
Yeah.
I don't know what it's called.
Yeah. It's okay. The Mind Flayer.
But, yeah, it kind of, like, the goosebumps on the back of his neck, you know. It kind of, like, we're like, oh. Like this
Vecna's not gone,
and it tied in the first season for
mm-hmm.
me, and it kind of like, okay, you know, this whole thing's coming undone now.
It's been Vecna the whole time. Yeah.
It was you the whole time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's scary. I really have to shout out Caleb McLaughlin and Sadie Sink for their standout performances this season. They were excellent. The scene where Max, obviously, spoiler alert, spoiler review, Max, when she, Vecna's got her, and we're so sure that, you know, she's dead, and it's just like, you know, Lucas is crying out, like, Erica, help me! Like, it was just, you feel his pain, and you feel his desperation, and it's just such an emotional scene. Like, they both killed it.
They did. No, but it... To the point where, well, speaking of being like worried about Max, it got to the point where like she was twisting and bending like that cheerleader in the trailer. Mm-hmm. So we were like, oh, Max is done.
Yeah.
Not to mention the way they shot this with the 7 different storylines happening at the same time during that scene. There was a point where I was like, Hopper's going to get it.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, then it cuts back to Max. Like, Max is going to get it.
Yeah.
It got to the point where I was like, is everybody going to die?
I know. It felt like that at one point.
That might be what's going on here. So, but like, correct me if I'm wrong, but we don't even know if Max is okay.
Yeah, she's in a coma in the hospital. That's where they leave her.
But speaking of that scene, you know, when he was trying to protect Max, Lucas did some Bruce Lee shit on that jock's ass.
Oh my God, right? He was such a badass. I was like, get him, Lucas!
Were we not waiting the whole season for
Lucas? For him to beat his ass,
whole season, I'm like, Lucas is eventually going to beat these...
I hated that jock. Oh, that actor did an amazing job playing that bully because he was very unlikable.
No, but like even at like the previous scene where they were at that cabin where Lucas misled them to the cabin, I'm like, eventually Lucas is going to beat his ass. Yeah. I was waiting for it the whole time.
Yeah.
So it was good to finally see some offense on Lucas's part.
I know. And when like the earthquake happened and like the floor split open and the jock was just like ripped in half, I was like, bye. That was awesome.
Yeah, no one cared.
Nobody cared. Everybody was like, see ya. Unfortunately, we did lose a character that everybody loves, that we loved, which was Eddie, played by Joseph Quinn.
I love it.
He was in the Upside Down. He was actually rocking out to Metallica, Master of Puppets. Yeah, most metal ever.
Which actually, this season takes place in 1986, which was the year of Master of Puppets.
That is so cool.
So that song would have been like brand spanking new at the time. So I love that. They totally made this like very 1986 with that song.
That was so cool. And his character this whole time, he reminded me of that character Eddie from Trick or Treat 1986. That's like a metal horror film.
It was definitely a shout out. What a lovable character. And mm-hmm. I always love the metalheads and the rockers, but I was surprised. Like, this guy's like a meme all over Instagram.
He's amazing. Like, I loved this actor's portrayal of this character, the way he goes out when he like, you know, saves Dustin and he like rides his bike off to get rid of the Demobats and they...
Well, he could have went with Dustin, but he's like, nah.
I'm not running anymore. And he, that part, that whole scene was like, oh my God, so emotional.
When he said, I'm not running anymore, did he mean like, because there was a good part of the season where he was running from the jocks.
I think that's what he meant. Yeah. I'm done running.
I'm sick of being scared. He's eating SpaghettiOs.
Yeah.
He's like hiding out. He's mm-hmm. like, I'm not doing this anymore.
Yeah.
So yeah, he's absolutely not a pussy, man. He's like, he's battling those bats or whatever.
They're like taking chunks out of him and he's still like, you know, beating him up.
He held his own for a while. Too.
Yeah. I
mean, dude.
And he's like, this is going to be my year, Henderson. I feel it. And I'm like, oh, like, that was so sad.
And I would say, like, out of the whole, like, they deserve better, like, crew.
Category, I feel like he was number one.
We got Barb. We got the Russian with the Slurpee.
Yeah.
And we got,
Billy.
We got Bob.
Bob, yeah.
So I feel like Eddie is like
Eddie's number one. I feel like deserves better.
Or he's at least that guy for this season.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So we're left to believe he's dead, but is he?
I don't know. I guess I'm pretty sure he is, but I guess if you know, break it down technically, maybe there could be a loophole where they could bring him back somehow. Like, I don't know.
Could he be in the Upside Down?
He could be, or maybe the government like said he was dead.
Far as the news reports go, he's missing.
Yeah.
But the news reports also think this whole thing's an earthquake.
Yeah.
So it's like
we'll have to find out. I mean, I'm pretty sure he's not going to come back. But if he did, I would be so thrilled.
Madonna, Blondie, Bowie, Beatles, music. We need music.
But I guess we'll find out.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. It would be cool. But like, either way, we got an awesome character.
Yes.
We got a really cool season out of this character. And
Yes, he was worth it.
We got the Funko Pop.
Yeah, we did.
We do. The Target exclusive.
Yes, we did.
Yeah, the Hellfire Club, dude.
Yeah.
Hellfire Club for life.
Yes.
We also got a t-shirt. There's t-shirts. There's everything.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I mean, talk about one character that came into the show that totally, like, brought a bunch of memes, a bunch of merch.
Yeah.
Very lovable character.
We also got, like, an awesome villain this season, which was
the best.
Vecna, who has actually been here this whole time. And it was, like, the whole story with that came full circle. And there was a big explanation about the Upside Down, which was great.
Now, I know Robert England's on board. Is Vecna's voice Robert England, or does it just remind
me of I think it's Jamie Campbell Bauer, so...
No, but that voice is so, like,
yeah.
Freddy Krueger-ish. Mm-hmm.
It does remind me of him, yeah, for sure.
No, I don't know for sure, but I'm like, this is... I don't know if they used his voice, but...
I don't think they did,
it's a creepy voice.
Yeah, it's very creepy.
That Vecna villain.
Yeah, no, they did a very, very good job with that.
He looks like Swamp Thing a little bit.
Yeah.
He reminds me of Swamp Thing.
Yeah, but, like a mixture of Swamp Thing and Freddy Krueger.
Yeah. Yeah, very cool
with dreads. I also love Steve Harrington, a.k.a. Joey Keery, and Robin, a.k.a. Maya Hawke. I loved both of their characters this entire season. They play so well off each other, and I feel like any scene, you put these two characters in a scene with any other actors from the show, and they vibe off them so well, and they just steal every scene they're in, and I just love the both of them. I think they're great.
I was really worried about Steve's, like, demise, because I thought it was coming, because...
They were focusing on the relationship, maybe the rekindling of the relationship between Nancy and Steve. And I'm like, oh no.
They had this whole scene where they were walking together in the woods. And Steve was completely, like, opening up. And I'm like, mm-hmm. This character is done. Because, yeah. I wonder what the plans are for this character now. Where does that leave John?
Jonathan, yeah. I don't know. I feel like Nancy and Steve are going to rekindle. Because the reason I think this is because the end of season 2, after they had broken up and Nancy was with Jonathan, when... Steve drops Dustin off at the middle school dance or whatever. Mm-hmm. That song Twist of Fate is playing in the background when Steve is staring at Nancy. And that's basically a foreshadowing. That was always foreshadowing for me. And I feel like that's going to come into fruition in season 5.
Could be. You really thought about this, huh?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah, you're like, this is how they're going to get together.
Yeah, well, I love Steve. So, and I think him and Nancy's badass. I think that they would make a great power couple. Sorry, Jonathan.
So where does this leave Jonathan?
He could be with Argyle. And we've got what we've all been waiting for, this part 2 of season 4. We got Joyce and Hopper's first kiss.
Yes, yes.
She, yay! And
she was wearing a Hulk Hogan shirt at one point.
Yeah, Rob noticed that.
That was awesome.
I love the chemistry that, like, that Joyce and Hopper have. I feel like it's just so palpable. It comes right off the screen at you. You feel it. You're so happy for them, and you root for them, like, every step of the way.
But back to the Hulk Hogan shirt.
Yeah.
it was.
I love the romance.
Joyce is a Hulkamaniac.
Yeah, okay. I guess right. So. Hopper probably is too, Rob. So there you go.
It's 1986. Hulkamania is running wild.
Well, there
man.
You go. There you go. I just really feel like each storyline is really comes full circle, and we get the group, the big group, like, all reunited again, which is what the purpose of every season of Stranger mm-hmm. Things is, because we want to see all these characters back together, interacting, you know,
you know,
all those different
you're right.
Things.
You're right. And to my point, and I think we're both right, because it is like, you know, everybody's together again, and mm-hmm. that part of it is a happy ending, but
yeah.
It ends where it still leaves us worried.
About Max,
yeah.
She's going to be okay, so, she's even really alive.
Things are better with everybody coming together, but things are not better as far as, like, the Upside Down and
yeah,
everything.
Yeah, looks
you know?
Like Vecna's going to take over the world.
Oh,
so.
There's still plenty to worry about, is
yeah.
what I'm saying.
Yeah,
so
for sure.
We were left on a cliffhanger, but
yes.
it is good, especially with... Hopper and
Joyce
and
Eleven. And yeah, I just love seeing all them, like, reunited, and that to me was what made the different storylines come full circle.
And there was a good scene with you know, Will and his brother.
Yes, that Jonathan, like, told him, he was like, remember when you got that Lego stuck up your nose and I was there for you? He's like, I'm just letting you know, I'll always be there for you no matter what. And it was just really sweet.
And that made me think, like, he's like, I know what's going on.
Yeah, I
he's
think like, Jonathan's smart. Yeah, he knows.
Yeah, he's like,
he was picking up on what was going
on. Basically, he said it without saying it. I'm mm-hmm. here for you no matter what you're going through, dude.
Yeah.
I'm your brother.
And yeah, and I love you.
Very touching. Very
yeah,
touching.
It was really sweet. So this season 4 of Stranger Things, I have to say, in my personal opinion, is the best season of the entire series.
Hands down.
I cannot wait for more. I can't wait to see where, you know, these questions are answered from, you know, the end of season 4. Is Max going to be okay? Where's Vecna? How is he going to try to take over the world? Like,
Is Eddie really dead?
Is Eddie really, really dead? Or is there a loophole where they can bring this character back, which would be amazing? So, we can't wait for season 5. Please comment your thoughts down below,
I do
guys.
Like how it ended, too, with, like, the Upside Down coming through the sky, like
yes.
I said. Like, dude, like, visually. And
yes.
Dude,
the cinematography, yeah.
This whole season... The monsters looked better. The upside down looked amazing. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is badass.
It was amazing.
This is straight up horror. Like, yeah. I love it. This is the most horror Stranger Things ever got.
Yeah, I love it.
This is straight up horror movie, like in a season. To me, I feel like this is so horror.
No, I agree. I think it's super horror-fueled, super passion-fueled. Like, you get everything you want in a series in the show, which is why it is my favorite show of all time. It's amazing. It's worth checking out. If you haven't even seen Stranger Things, why are you watching the video? But check it out, definitely.
because we're awesome.
Yeah, well, there you go.
And that's why they're watching the video.
There you go. if you could, guys, like this video. Hit the bell to be notified about all of our future videos. Subscribe to our channel for more awesome horror content and reviews. Stay till the end of the video. Click some of the other videos we have to offer. Some reviews, trailer reactions, things like that.
We got a lot to offer.
We do. So make sure you're hitting that subscribe button and that bell. Once again, I'm Kaylee.
And I'm Rob.
And we'll see you guys back in the Upside Down.
Thanks for watching.
That horror couple.
And they talk about horror.
Like and subscribe.